Hello everyone, this is Hoda Ganji. In this video I'm going to create some curtain panels. I'm gonna open a new file, metric architectural, okay. First I would like to check the units. I'm gonna type UN. For length we have millimeters, it's good, okay, okay. So let's start with creating a curtain panel. I'm gonna go with exterior glazing, just drawing a wall here. And basically you see it's transparent and we have kind of some grid for mullions, but we don't have mullions yet. So one of the things about curtain panels is that although by default it's set to be transparent, it does not have to be transparent, right? So let's say I want to create a curtain panel and I want this one to be a concrete curtain panel or a concrete curtain wall. Okay, and now first I want to maybe get rid of that horizontal grid over there, so I can change the horizontal grid to known. Delete grid line, yes, okay. I want to go back to edit type, and for the curtain panel I want to change this to one of the basic walls. For instance, I want to go with generic 200 millimeters. Okay, now you see that we actually have opaque walls. Okay, I want to go to one of the generic ones, maybe that 200, edit type. Let's say I want to create a sandwich panel wall. And it's going to be concrete. I'm going to assume that at the core we have like 8 inches of insulation. You can directly type 8 inches. It's going to automatically convert it into millimeters, and this is going to be the insulation at the middle. I should have like a cavity fall. I'm going to go with this. Feel free to change the pattern for the hatch or even the color. If I go with a pattern, how about I also add a solid color to the background? I just want to show you that you can go with a mix and match. Okay, and let's say I want to have one layer at the top. It's gonna be a finish layer. One layer at the bottom, it's also gonna be a finish layer. I want to change these two layers to concrete. This one as well is going to be concrete. And I want each of them to be like 1 inches, 1 inch, 1 inch over here. So it's going to add up to 10 inches, 8 plus 1 plus 1. I'm going to say OK. And you can also see the thermal resistance over there. That comes from the thermal properties here, and also for the concrete material, this is the thermal properties of the concrete material. Based on this thickness, which is 10 inches, it's going to be about 3.5 for the RSI, which is not very high. I'm going to say OK. OK. I want to draw this wall. So if I change this to like fine, this to like shaded, this is my sandwich panel wall made out of concrete and insulation. I want to select this wall. I want to go to edit type, and you remember I assigned basic wall here. Now I want to change it to my sandwich panel wall. It was not here before. Now that I created that, I can select it from here. Okay, and if I go to like level 1 WT, put the two views side by side. I want to also change this to like shaded or something. You see that basically this is now a curtain panel, right? And it's made out of concrete sandwich panels. Okay, I want to get rid of this wall. I just wanted to have it so I can assign it to that wall. I want to put this back to TW, so it's going to be tab view. Let's say we want to have another wall and it's going to be more like a metal wall. So I want to maybe copy this here. I want to go to edit type, duplicate, and this is gonna be metal. I'm gonna actually change this back to like basic wall or something. I need to go create another wall. I'm gonna go to wall, architectural, sandwich panel. We already have it. I'm gonna go to edit type and duplicate. And I want to go with metal stud panels. Okay. Let's say maybe we're gonna keep that insulation, but on the two sides, maybe we have some metal siding. I want to check what we have for metals here. We have metal stud layer, metal deck, etc., etc. You can also create your own material, rename it, and name it as metal siding. I want to go to the asset browser. I want to type metal siding. And under siding, we can take a look here. I want to go with maybe one of these dark gray metal panels. Dark gray. Okay, I want to close this. So the material is assigned. That seems good. Okay, so this is on one side, the other one is gonna be on the other side, it's gonna be maybe the same thing, or if this is gonna be exterior, so let's say in this case your exterior side finish is gonna be metal, so I'm gonna assign that metal siding here, but this side, which is interior side, I wanna go with a plywood sheeting actually, and let's say I wanna add another layer. Move it down. This is gonna be my finish. And for this one, I wanna go with some kind of plaster, gypsum wall board, that's good. And this is also gonna be like 1 inch. So this all seems good. Okay. And okay. So now I have this wall. This is my metal stud panel. Right, I want to actually select this second ketonmap panel, go to edit type and change this to metal stud panel wall. Okay, I want to get rid of this, go to level one. So this is the other one. Actually, this side is inside, so I want to kind of maybe flip it. So now this side is inside, this side is outside. And you see that we don't have like the mullions here. You can also add mullions if you want. You can just select the panel, go to edit type, and for the vertical mullions, we have the options to assign interior mullions and border type 1, type 2 on the two sides. And if you go here, you see that we have, for instance, options to go for rectangular mullion or other ones. Let's say I want to go with this one, or for instance, for the two corners, two outside edges, you can go with quad corner. Let's say it's going to be the corner. Okay, and okay. So now you see that that actually is assigned here. So the size of that mullion is 50 by 150. If you want to change the size, you can go to families, go to curtain panel, wall mullions actually. Let's say rectangular 50 by 150. I want to duplicate this. If you want to go with some different dimensions, let's say 50 by 200, you can change it here, assign your values. Just make sure to duplicate it. A material could be aluminium, or if you want to go with steel, you can change this from here. Let's see if you have any steel here. Yeah, I'm gonna go with one of these. Steels, stainless steel. That's good. Okay. And now I can go back to my curtain panel. If I go to my edit type, scroll down here, that item is added to my vertical mullions. I can go with this one, maybe for the two edges as well. Okay, I'm gonna just make sure that the numbers are good. You can go with different profiles too. For instance, you can go with C-shape profiles if you want. Let's go with this one. Right? And now you see that basically these are C-shape profiles. If I go to level 1, you can see this better. So this is the C-shape profile. If you want it to kind of look a little bit more bold, you can do this. We can go to visibility graphics. It's under my curtain panels, curtain panel, wall mullions. For this, I can change the cut pattern to a solid fill. In this case, because I want to go with a solid color, it doesn't matter if it's foreground or background. I want to change this to solid fill, change this to black. Okay, apply. And so now this is the wall. Let's say you want the mullions to be a bit close to each other. We can do this. We can go here, select this, go to edit type, and then I want to change the vertical grid fixed distance. They're going to be far apart every 2 feet, so I'm going to change this to 24 inches. Apply. Okay, now you see that the mullions are close to each other, right? And if you want to add another layer, which is kind of just in front of this panel, you might go with a simple wall. If for some reason you need a continuous layer, you can go with one of the generic walls. Edit type, duplicate, maybe this is generic 100 millimeters. Or 50 millimeters, 5 centimeters. Okay, and I want to go with okay. I want to change this to finish face interior, and I'm gonna go from here, hit a space, and I want to finish it here. So now if I go here, this is actually a separate layer. I'm gonna leave this as it is, or maybe you don't need this final layer, so you can get rid of it. How about I move this wall over here? I want to select this wall, go to move, and move it from here all the way to here. Right? Now, the problem here is that these two walls are kind of a little bit different in thickness, so they're not going to be matching on the exterior or interior side. Right. In that case, now if I move one of these walls, let's say if I select this one, I want to go with move, so I want to go with move this from here to here. Because the two are joined, it's going to join the walls automatically. You cannot align them, right? So in this case, you need to select one of the curtain panels, right click on this little blue circle, go to disallow join. Then select the other curtain panel, right click here, disallow join, and now I can select this panel, go with move, so move over there, and then I can move this over here. Now they are aligned on one side, so this is the exterior side. You can also align them on the interior side.